Welcome to Train Sim World 2, an immersive and highly detailed rail simulation featuring authentic routes and trains from around the world.
How's it going, everyone? This is Ash, and a warm welcome to my latest Let's Play of Train Sim World 2. And this is the very first time I've covered this Kent High Speed route with the Class 395 Hitachi Javelin trains. And without further ado, let's get started.
You've just been awarded some action points. These are displayed in the top right corner of the screen and count towards your overall experience. It is necessary to be fully observant of the surrounding world. Practice by looking up, down, left, and right.
Okay, we've just done that part. Obviously, this is the introduction, and it does walk you through the obvious controls and stuff, just in case this is the first route you come across. So, love is obvious. So,
this is one of many interactives to be discovered, but not all of them will be as easy to find as this one.
Oh, by the way, folks, this is one of the unlockables, and they've decided to redo this part of the first scenario that comes with the route, as there is some bugs with the tutorial, and I will explain as we go through. Okay, so if you are struggling to get this train moving, you have to close the doors first, although the tutorial doesn't tell you that, but I will show you what you need to do. And fingers crossed on this attempt, we should get the train successfully moving. I will say this as well, folks. I do like the Class 395s, as they do have a very futuristic look to them. So what we're heading towards now is just the last coach before we go into the cab. So we'll set up the table seat just to clear the tasks.
You can pause the experience at any point and review previous and current objectives. Check it out now and then return to the game when ready.
Okay, this is the part that's coming up that is not covered in the tutorial. And newcomers to the world of Train Sim World 2 will probably find this confusing. So what I'm going to do, I'll walk you through what you need to do. So I'm just going to close this cab door off.
Operating trains, so when ready, sit in the driver's seat.
Okay, we'll just jump in the chair and I'll walk you through what you need to do.
A heads-up display has appeared on the right-hand side of the screen. This is a guide to what the train is doing. This is the speed display. The white needle shows current speed. The red marker indicates the maximum permitted speed.
Okay, very much self-explanatory stuff there. It's just walking you through the heads-up display. This is definitely for newcomers, but getting the train moving, I will show you what to do, what the tutorial doesn't, okay?
This is the direction display. An arrow will indicate forward, reverse, and neutral directions. The This is the power display. A number will indicate what position the power control is in. These are the brake indicators. They show the state of the various brake systems, allowing independent management of them. In the top right are the signal and speed limit displays. These feature an indication of what is approaching and a countdown distance to when they'll come into effect. Some of these displays can be hidden via the settings menu for a more challenging experience. This train is ready to go. Pull the indicated handle towards you to get moving.
Right, folks, I just need to clear something up here first. If you do that, the tutorial will glitch out. So what you'll have to do first, press tab, lock the doors, and then take power, okay? Otherwise, the brakes will not release. So, that's now all done. So what we can do, we can now take the power. So we'll take our cursor down here, and we will move the power into knock setting 2, and the train should now move. If you don't close the doors first, folks, just like I showed you there, the tutorial will glitch out.
Is one of the major London terminals, providing access to both national and international services. This particular train is a Class 395 Javelin built by Hitachi in Japan for European operation. It is formed of 6 cars and has a top speed of 225 kilometers per hour. Trains in World allows you to ride and drive from a selection of camera views. Let's take a look now while exploring this train. We've only explored a small area here, so let's take a look at what else there is to enjoy. Welcome to the southeast of England. Drive the nation's fastest domestic train from the heart of London at St Pancras International. Race along the high-speed lines via Ebbsfleet International, whilst reaching speeds of up to 225 kilometers per hour. Operate or join the mainline commuter trains through the historic towns in Medway to Faversham in Kent. High-speed express and mainline commuter, you choose the pace. Along the way, don't forget to place route maps, install safety signs, set up newspaper stands, and repair broken fences. Welcome to Southeastern High Speed.
Okay, that is the end of this first video let's play of Trains in World 2 with the Southeastern High Speed route that goes from London St Pancras to Faversham. I do like the Class 395s, so I wanted to cover this one. Although I do tend to cover mostly American trains, it does make a nice change to do something different every now and again. But anyways, just remember to lock the doors first before moving the power handle, as that was not covered in the tutorial. Although I thought of it anyways, but it can catch you off guard if you're not careful. But anyways, that's all for now, folks. Big thank you for watching. Take care of yourselves and each other, and I will see yous in the next upload coming very soon.